During rainy season, you must have seen a green cover on rocks and walls. This is actually the bryophyte. These bryophytes are known as the amphibians of the plant kingdom. Why are they called amphibians of the plant kingdom? Because to complete its life cycle, it requires both land as well as water. Now let us study the bryophytes in detail. Bryophytes are having a thallus where there are no true roots, leaves and stem. There are root-like structures called rhizoids, which may be unicellular or multicellular. Then they have got a thallus which is haploid and it acts as a gametophyte because it produces gametes. There are two types of gametophytes, male gametophytes and female gametophytes. The male gametophytes produce anthridial head and female gametophytes produce archegonial head. The anthridia are the male reproductive parts of bryophytes, which produce biflagellate anthrozoids, whereas archegonia, they produce the egg. So the egg is fertilized by the anthrozoids, which are released into the water. So water is essential for the fertilization. So after the egg is fertilized, a zygote is formed. This zygote grows into a sporophyte, which is diploid. Some cells of the sporophyte undergo meiosis and produce the small spores. These spores, when they germinate, they develop into the gametophyte again. This is how it is, the life cycle is completed. Bryophytes are further divided into liverworts and mosses. Let us study what are they. Liverworts are the lower bryophytes. They are primitive bryophytes where the body is a typical thallus, which is dorsiventrally branched. Sometimes some leaf-like structures may also be present in leafy liverworts. And these leaf-like structures have a small stem, which is not true stem, it's a false stem. The method of reproduction in liverworts may be both asexual as well as sexual. In asexual, there may be fragmentation, or they may have a small asexual structures called gamete. These gamete may separate from the thalloid structure and develop into a new thallus. Okay, so this is the asexual reproduction in liverworts. So these gamma cups are very predominantly are used for asexual reproduction. Next comes the sexual reproduction. In sexual reproduction, there are anthridia and archegonia, which may be present on the same or in different thallus. Next comes the mosses. Mosses may be sphagnum, funaria or polytrichum. Mosses are the advanced bryophytes where the false differentiation is there in terms of roots, leaves and small stem. Then the moss gametophyte is divided into two parts, protonema stage and leafy stage. Initial stage is protonema. The protonema, the spore develops into protonema, which is a small filamentous structure which develops into later on into a leafy gametophyte, which is called leafy stage. So this leafy stage further develops into the male gametophyte and female gametophyte. So now let us see this leafy stage. This leafy stage, when it grows, it produces multicellular rhizoids, and these multicellular rhizoids absorb the nutrition from the soil. Now, methods of reproduction again can be vegetative or sexual. Vegetative reproduction may be by fragmentation or by budding in secondary protonema stage, whereas the sexual reproduction is by the same as in case of liverworts. It has got male gametophyte and female gametophyte in a similar way. So gametophyte, let us see the economic importance of these bryophytes. Bryophytes are used for making peat, which is a fuel, source of fuel. And bryophytes have a lot of ecological importance because they cover the soil and help in retaining the water, and it helps in more percolation of water. So along with lichens, these bryophytes are also responsible for corroding the rocks and help in the soil production. So we can say that bryophytes are ecologically very important for the development of further types of the plants because they enrich the soil.